pulse of humanity turned on the time.
Govan has a fantastic, a really outstanding shipbuilding story to tell. There's still a thriving shipyard here, and we hope that that will continue for a long time. But we've had shipbuilding on this site for the past 150 years, 1864 to 2014. This is the first place, the first time this story will be told. We were aware that this building had been lying derelict for 7 or 8 years. It was in a terrible condition. It was lying boarded up and it was sending out a very negative message about Govan. It's like Govan is closed. So we made a few complaints about the state of the building. We asked if there were any plans for it. We discovered that several options had been looked at, none of them successful, and eventually in 2008 the owners, Clydeport, asked us if we wanted to consider it for business use. I don't think there's any doubt the biggest challenge has been the dreadful condition of the building. It lay derelict for eight full years. And the water was pouring into the building when we took over. So a lot of dry rot, wet rot, major structural problems. And when you take a building on in that condition, you really don't know what the challenges are until you start down takings and demolitions and discover how bad it really is. So when we started the project, I knew we didn't have enough money to do it to the kind of standard that we wanted, but we were determined to grab the opportunity to start at least when it was available. So the biggest challenge has been continuing to improve the building, secure more money to do that, and really to achieve the kind of quality that we aspire to at the very beginning.
3, 2, 1,
today marks the end of our emergency repairs works, which we've been doing for the last year and a half to save the building.
I'm Gillian Gilmartin, and I was over here to see the restoration of the Fairfields, and I got to unveil a statue, what was amazing! And Tom and them are jealous.
Damn right.
It's fantastic. I can't believe the detail, the architecture. I mean, look at that. Look at those. Turn your camera to that. Right. Those last things, light switches like that. It's amazing. Sorry. It's the right word. It's a time capsule, almost. It's like a time capsule.
It all goes back to 1834. When a company of engineers in Glasgow began business in Tradeston. And they practiced as general engineers, and it wasn't till a few years later, 1852, that they were joined by a young engineer called John Elder. And John Elder was a hugely talented engineer, some people would say a genius, and he brought to this company the whole business of marine engineering. And he did this through quite a remarkable development, which was the refinement of the compound marine engine. And the compound engine was a remarkable development at that particular time because it revolutionized sea transportation. It enabled ships to go further, and it enabled them to do so far cheaper than before. In 1859, the company decided to begin shipbuilding in a small yard in Govan, right beside Water Row. And this they do for a few years, but so successful is their business that they decide they have to think along grander lines. They acquire a large tract of land in 1864 at farmland known as Fairfield, Fairfield Farm. And at Fairfield, Randolph and Elder lay out what can only be described in today's terms as a super yard. Hitherto, shipyards in the Clyde are between 5 and 10 acres in size, but what he proposes is a 40-acre shipyard, later extended to about 70. We would term this today as a superyard. And here, we understand and we like to think that this is all John Elder's doing. He lays out this incredible shipyard, which is a shipyard, an engine works, and a very large dock where ships can be fitted out. And this pattern of shipbuilding really sets the standard for what's to come everywhere else in the world. So this is a hugely significant development that takes place in Govan in 1864. But unfortunately, in 1869, John Elder dies, unfortunately, unable to see his work at Fairfield completed, although he did see many ships launched there. But the whole scheme was not really completed until about 1870, 1871. William Pierce joins Fairfield shortly after the demise of John Elder. Pierce is a naval architect, a man from Kent who studied or served his apprenticeship at Chatham Royal Dockyard. He comes to the Clyde as shipyard manager and eventually becomes the managing director of the Fairfield Company. Undoubtedly, William Pierce, later Sir William Pierce, is the man who took Fairfield to the number one position in terms of shipbuilding in the world. He's also very important because he's the man who sowed the seeds for the building that we're in right now. Unfortunately, he too died rather early and didn't see the building complete, but his ambition was to have magnificent headquarters for the world's leading shipyard. And that's what we see here today.
This wasn't just another redundant building. This was one of the most important buildings in Govan for the community. People have got very, very rich historical associations with this building because their families worked here, their grandparents worked here, they heard stories about it. So there's an amazing fondness for this building. And we wanted not just to deliver another business centre or workspace, but to do something different that would reflect the community's attachment to this building. And that's where the Heritage Project came from. We wanted to develop a project that would tell the community stories, a story about shipbuilding in Govan, and that's what we've done. This has in the past been a fabulous building. We wanted to give it back as a fabulous building. You look at the building now, Govan's open for business again. Humanity turned on the tide, and the nation that depended on ships for its trade turned a blind eye on the price that was paid. For cold as the mist on the river,